Jessica, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
So I'm interested in the DNA of Camuto Group. And when you go out and you walk into Camuto's store, what is the DNA? For example, in the past, we've had Lacoste appear on the stage, and they said that their DNA, you walk in a store, it's a blank canvas so that they can put their polos up with different colors. We heard from Diesel, and they said that their DNA is the ability to bring DJs and music in so they can actually have music, and they sort of create the store with that environment. What would you say is the DNA for the Camuto Group?
The DNA for Camuto Group is boiled down to three words: lux for less. We really believe that we deliver a high quality product for a lower retail price point than the consumer would expect. And we try to make the store space represent that shell and core brand image. So we have a lot of plush fabrics and a lot of really high-end finishes in the store space that is unique across the world in all of our stores.
So when you're looking for a lease to enter into, what are you looking for?
For us, a core space is usually about 1,500 square feet. And we feel that because we're really a footwear and accessory handbag business, we need a smaller footprint just to make sure we optimize our profit opportunities. We also look for key locations, like anybody would. But for us, those key locations would be near other people who are attracting the same clientele. So other fashion companies, department store flankers, and really right now, more urban city locations.
I know you're moving into the Disney space. That's quite an experience. I have to say that's one of the most difficult leases I've ever worked on.
Same.
Yeah. They handled a little bit differently, and I know you had a little bit of a different strategy with the entering into the Disney.
We did. We're treating that more like it would be a flagship. So that is going to actually have a full representation of all product categories under the Vince Camuto brand. And we felt we could take on a bigger foot space there and square footage because of how they do structure their leases, where it's really derived based on your profits and your success in that space. So we figure, why not roll the dice and push for greater success?
Yeah, it's an interesting. We've heard a number of different CEOs mention they'd like to see landlords take a bigger stake in the success of the company. And this is one type of lease that does that, where their pay is really based on how well you do. So it'll be an interesting experiment.
Yes.
So for foreign markets, where has been a good place for the Camuto Group to open stores?
The Camuto Group has had an amazing partner in the Middle East, and we've had astounding growth there and a really great reception to the brand, which is still a young brand. We've really only had a good big push in the brand for about 5 to 6 years now. Other places where we want to try to grow and our key markets that we're looking to for the future include China and Europe. We've also obviously had great success with our North American border partners in Canada.
And then in the U.S., what would you say are the hot cities for you?
For us, we've been doing really well in warm client spaces. So I would say Florida and California. But a big growth opportunity right now and a target for us is Texas, particularly Austin is a big city that we're looking to for future growth.
The Camuto Group's very interesting because they have their own brand, but they're equally known for, I guess, assisting other brands. So you do All Saints, Tory Burch, Jessica Simpson. How do you balance that? I mean, you have two different scenarios that you sort of have to deal with.
Yeah, it makes my role in particular in the company very unique. But I think what we really do is try not to cannibalize the growth opportunities for all of those brands. So we look for individual DNA for each brand so that they all have their own personality, their own consumer reach, and, you know, through that and through different price point structures, we tend to be able to optimize growth for each brand, and we still do not suppress growth for any other individual brand.
You guys did something really interesting that a lot of companies dream about, and you guys actually did it. You ran a Super Bowl ad. As we know, that's the most expensive advertising you can buy, and I'm always interested in learning whether this was worth the money? How did it go with
the... The opportunity actually came to us. We weren't looking for the opportunity. And we ran in the 30 minutes before the Super Bowl started, before kickoff, which gives you a little bit better ROI. So it went really well. I think we had a great favorable reception within the industry, but also with consumers. It was a really cute ad. I think that adds value. It is memorable, a talking dog. So, but it speaks to the consumer, because anybody who's had a dog and high-end footwear has had an experience go awry there, including myself. So,
but you got a lot of press really prior to the ad, the buildup for it.
We did. The buildup was great. We did very targeted social media through our own platforms. We picked up and partnered with Footwear News and with other industry partners. So we did get a lot of advanced press. And we probably got more of the ROI from the advanced press than maybe the airing itself, but it was all great value.
Great. Well, I really appreciate you taking the time to meet with us today and give us some insight.
So I was happy to come. Thank you.